Hi, I'm Kim Field from Arlington, Texas. This pipeline blockade is important to me because I'm a parent, but I understand that the low-hanging fossil fuel fruit is not available anymore. It is economically unsustainable as well as environmentally unsustainable.
My name is Sam Avery. I'm from Hart County, Kentucky. And fossil fuel extraction in the form of mountaintop removal, fracking, and tar sands is the environmental issue of our time.
My name is Rebecca Waters, and I am from Galveston, Texas. And I have watched over the many years that I've been there the organisms disappear from the Gulf of Mexico on the beaches of Galveston. There used to be all kinds of animals on the beach all the time, crabs, all kinds of seashells, tons of different kinds of jellyfish in the water. They're all gone, especially since the BP oil spill. And today we are discussing the XL pipeline that's coming down from Canada, and it is wrong for these companies to take advantage of the populations that live in these areas. They destroy the environment and the habitats that the animals, the organisms, the forests, the people that live in those environments need, and it's wrong.
I'm Tammy Carson. I'm from Arlington, Texas, and I'm here because I'm outraged at what people with money and power are doing to our earth. It's not just mine, it's my kids, it's my grandkids, it's all of ours, and the potential for the destruction of it is not okay, and I'm here to say it's not okay. Ready to put myself on the line to make that statement.
My name is Gary Stewart. I'm a native Texan, currently living in Dallas, Texas. The reason why I'm here, multiple reasons, but one, deeply concerned about the rapid deterioration of the environment. I'm 54 years old. I found out about this stuff in the late 80s and became an environmental activist as well as a peace activist. And over that time, it's gotten worse and worse and worse. Though there have been advances, the general trend is destruction. And I finally am convinced that the current political situation, system that we have, from local, state, national, at least, is corrupt. It is not working. There are some good people who are able to do some things, but the cards are stacked against us. And I realize it's time for direct action.
Yes, my name is Benjamin Butler. I'm from Denton, Texas. And this action is very, very important to me. I think that people are starting to realize that going through more traditional means of change aren't working anymore. And that we basically have to put ourselves and our bodies on the line. And I've felt really empowered by joining this community here. It's really powerful being around individuals who are so committed to standing up for the planet and what they feel is right. So, yeah, that's why this is important to me.
Okay. My name is Alejandro De La Torre. I'm from Houston, Texas. And I'm here because runaway climate change is my number one priority. I think that everybody needs to really, you know, get on that fight. And we're talking about the deaths of billions of people. That's what, you know, scientific community is assuring us that would result from that. So we really need to make that an issue and take direct action. So.
My name is Benjamin Franklin, and I'm from Houston. I'm part of Occupy Houston, and I'm a Unitarian Universalist, and the divinity and sacredness of the planet, as well as the interconnectivity of all beings, is a key part of our religious values. So climate change in general applies to that, and then here particularly in, you know, I live in Houston, so that's the terminus of this horrible evil project that's causing pain and suffering across the planet and will cause more. So I have to go and do something.
My name's Leaf. I'm from Houston, and I live at the base of about 2 miles away from my backyard is the sixth largest oil refinery in the United States, which is Shell. And the air stinks, people get sick, the water's polluted, and people don't care. They're completely apathetic because it's money in their pocket. And so I think there needs to be a resistance to wake these people up and show them that we're in their backyard and they can't profit off of our livelihoods, our future, our lives.
Okay, my name is Jane Peekle. I'm coming from Natchitoches, Louisiana. And I guess for me, I'm a native Pennsylvanian. And, you know, I've kind of, the last couple years, kind of watched, feeling kind of helpless as, you know, my home state gets really torn up with fracking. And, you know, the government, the DEP up there, doesn't do anything to help out these poor people who are falling victim to just, you know, wells popping up overnight on their land and, you know, water that can be lit on fire. And now that I live down here, I'm feeling pretty empowered to, you know, fight what is basically the same fight. Now I'm fighting tar sands, but it's all connected. And so I feel like I'm fighting for Pennsylvania, I'm fighting for Louisiana, for Texas, and for the whole country.
My name's Alice Melendez, I was Johnston before, and I'm from Kentucky, so I know about mountaintop removal mining too, personally, but I come down to Houston, and I know that from living there and the way that money flows in Houston, I know oil, it's how important it is to our economy and our whole way of life. But I know that this super extractive way of mining, like, I've always believed and fought with economics professors in college and stuff about the fact that mining is the base value of our economy, that the base value of our life comes out of the ground by not paying Mother Earth what it takes for it to be produced. And here I am, like, in the center of money and power of the world in Houston, I feel like. And Occupy comes up all around the world, and I saw this chance. Occupy, by being in solidarity with each other, we can actually face it. And it's the same with extractive mining. Only by being in solidarity all around the world at the same time can we face extractive mining as the core of our culture and switch to something else before it's too late for our planet. And so this really means a lot to me.
So I'm Kells, I'm from Denton right now. And this is really important because we don't have another planet. Like, I believe in the end of all oppression and the remaking of society. And you can't do that if you literally have nothing to remake it on. We are nowhere near the technology to clean up what's been done, and we can't. There's no more. There's no more ground that can be lost. There's no more compromises that can be made. We're at the point where that's not an option anymore.
My name is Mary Malterhari. I'm from Denton, Texas, and this is important to me because what I do know scares me, but what I don't know scares me more. I'm just trying to learn.
I'm Mary Francis from Norman, Oklahoma, and I have been an activist for 50 years. I'm 70. And I do what I do, not because I think I'm going to win. I do it because it's the right thing to do. And when my granddaughter asks me, Grandma, how did you let it get this way? I'm going to be able to say, sweetheart, I never stopped trying to fix it.
My name is Aiden Creasy, and I'm from Austin, Texas. I'm here because I feel, as a white person who benefits from white privilege and settler privilege on stolen land, that it's my responsibility to do what I can to stand in solidarity with Indigenous people in Alberta, Canada, who are under assault. And I'm here because I want to get in between what's left of this planet and fossil fuels. I'm here because I want to see an escalation in our movements so that we resolve to physically stop, by whatever means necessary, the fossil fuel industries and shut them down permanently, so that we have a small chance, a chance, any chance, for there to be a livable planet, not just for our human grandchildren, but for the grandchildren of the trees here, for the other members of our greater living community. And that's what brings me here. I also don't want to see the lives and homes of these folks in East Texas and elsewhere to be destroyed by this pipeline. And I am deeply honored to be included to work with all the fine folks here who are doing amazing things. I really hope that we can muster the courage to be honest with ourselves about what needs to be done, the sacrifices that we need to make to ensure that we have the basics: breathable air, drinkable water, and yeah, that's why I'm here.